So let us get on to the topic, how to write or how to use GUT in Godot. First of all, let me say, writing tests in general is an own science. And you can improve a lot, and also writing tests is kind of messy, if you want to call it like that. You can write tests which are very good code or with helper functions and stuff like that, just to initialize stuff. I normally just go the way and write everything down as I want in my test, because in the end I always think it's better to have tests instead of no tests. Yeah, I think a big part of testing code is also to refactor or writing good test code. The best is to at least have some tests. You will improve writing your tests as soon as you write more tests, and then you will always see if you, of course, change something in your code or in your software especially, which changes the tests. You always have, of course, to re-execute your tests and see if everything is behaves the same way as before. Yeah, sometimes it is a bit annoying if you know you have tested a function in a behavior before. Yeah, let's stick to my example here. So in my case, I have a combat, for example, and I just initialize a new combat method, and normally the combat object is just empty and nothing is in there. I assume that there isn't a combat happening. So the function is combat happening, just checks if combat is happening or not. Of course, I expect to have a false here, but if I now, in later part of my software development, decide that, oh, it's not good to have a false, instead I want to have some kind of enum with a state maybe. So I have a combat state of no combat, combat will happening, or combat is happening. So I have more options than just two. In this case, of course, I would have to refactor all my tests I have written here as well. So if I change the return type of the is combat happening, then I have to think about it that I also have to change and modify all my test codes. And this is a bit of annoying part, because if you have written tests before of and everything is fine, and then you change some return values, you always have to keep in mind that you have to modify your tests. If you don't do that in time, then you will change a lot of your code, and afterwards all your tests aren't working anymore. And then when you just run, when you just came up with the idea, I just want to rerun my tests now, and then you have something like 50 tests failing, then I can guarantee you, you won't have the mood to test then all to change then all of your tests, because this is very exhausting and frustrating if you know your code is working but all your tests needs to be modified. This is some kind of an annoying part of using the test. So in this particular case, I just can tell you, if you change something in your code behaviors, always run your tests afterwards and check if everything is fine, and just do the modifications as soon as you have some failed test, because if you stack up failed tests, you won't be it won't be easy to get back into testing. And sometimes I just then delete all my tests instead of modify them, because I think, oh, now the tests aren't working anymore, and so they don't have the right behavior that they should be. That said, it was longer than I expected, so I just wanted to start to give you some overview about testing in GUT. For the GD script in Godot, you can just write normal code as you do in your software as well. The testing code isn't different to anything you write in Godot. And you can of course use all the features of the language you have before. The only thing you have to keep in mind is, if you write down, or if you create your tests, you have of course have to place it somewhere. As I told before in my introduction video to GUT, I have the folder structure tests and then unit, and in my unit folder I have all my unit tests, starting with test underscore. So this is my prefix for the GUT, that he knows everything with test underscore are my scripts to test in. If you create then the test script, you need to make sure to extend it from the add-ons GUT test GD, that you have all the test stuff available, and that GUT is aware of that this script belongs to our unit test. Afterwards, you just can name your functions however you want. I don't think that you even need the test underscore, but I think it's kind of good practice to just naming my test function always with the start of test underscore. And then I try to give them a very good and readable name. So the test function in general, or usually in my code, are pretty long. So if I write normal code, I try to have, of course, meaningful functions, but I try to keep them as short as possible. In my test functions, I always try to keep them to give the tests very meaningful names instead of shorten them, because you don't want to comment a whole lot in your test files, but you also want to know if something is broken or if something is not working as expected, what the test is actually doing. So in this case, if I have the function test combat is happening, no armies, by that I mean that I'm testing my combat script if the combat state is in the right position, if there are no armies at all. So by that I just mean we have to think about good functions that you and also your collaborators. If you're working on a bigger team, it's more important than just for me. So for me, I just name the functions that I can remember what I tried to achieve here. If you are in a team, also your team members would like to know what you do. So try to think about meaningful names. Yeah, afterwards in the function, you can just do everything as you can do in a normal GD script file. The only difference is then we have, of course, all the assert functions from our GUT test GD, where we can then test everything together. So assert equal is normally the most used assert function, because with assert equal you can just compare two values with each other. So in this case, I just use my combat is happening function and just compare the return value of my function to false in this case. Or as you can see here, I have an army, I have a building, and this means that a combat is happening and this is true. Just one last point, as you can see here, for example, here are stuff that I initialize at the start of the function. And if you're writing good test code, you can also, of course, having some kind of an init armies function, and then you can, of course, move that block to some kind of return function, and then you can of course go to the bottom and write some private function. So of course you could do something like that, and then you could use this function in other tests if you are always want to initialize some kind of the same object or like that. So also your test code can be cool and can be refactored, and you should always think about it. And even if you're writing 3-4 times the same initialization, you should maybe think about to extract them to some private function and make also your test code a bit more readable. Just one more sentence. To execute the test, I always like to use my command line, and there I can just type in GUT, and then GUT is executed, and you can see here the run summary of our tests. So we have 54 tests passed, 0 of them failed, and the test took me about 0.23 seconds. You can also run the test on Godot itself. So you have your test scene created. I told you in the first video, yeah, it's this one with the GUT object. Then you could just run the play scene. And also here are the same tests executed, and then you have kind of this GUI tool, and you must click it and you must close it and you must finish it, and then you can go back to your test. For me, the better approach is to using my command line, because I'm using two displays. I have it on my left display. I can just write my tests here and then can get over to my command line and just execute them.